tend to get in there, bud?
Yeah, should have. Maybe just pull forward a bit.
Check my lot too, but since I saw these guys, I took the opportunity to sneak in front of them, and I'll be stopping a couple of kilometers down the road in a parking bay, quickly check and keep going before they start. I don't have to overtake them on the road. Yeah. The parking sign doesn't exist anymore. My tactics work. No, can't see them coming, so here I go. Beautiful. I managed to way before the oversizes. How nice is that? Fixing this shoulders of the rod and making them wider, it's actually making our life so much easier, especially when oversizes are coming and we have to pull over. Yeah, making the life a lot more easier. You drive more relaxed, even when it's no oversizes of that, because when something is coming from opposite direction, you know you got that extra bit there that you can move to the left, not to pass so close to the incoming vehicle, so it does make the life a lot more easy. table. And it's going for about 26 kilometers, if I'm not wrong. Anyway, around 20 kilometers. Straight and flat. Few bushes here, there, but yeah, nothing else. Just a straight road and flat as. Summertime, you can't even see the road. You just see the heat waves emerging from the road. It's like the road end up in a water. Yeah, it's unbelievable. Okay, it's been 5 hours since I left Newman. So, time for my break and also lunch at the same time. How good was that I had to stop? Otherwise, I was gonna be forced to stop further down the road because of the big one. Well, so far so good. Looks like I'm lucky. There they come again. very good to go. By the time I catch up speed, you'll be gone. This was perfect. Spotted this hole right in time. Okay, so now I'll be unhooking from middle trailer, then park the lid somewhere, then hook back and use the middle one as a lid with the forklift dog and back to Perth. Okay, so I'm out of this madness on a way to Perth.
I'll see when you get back. Yeah, what's your mind doing?
Every single one will hurt. angle, and that was 1400 kilometers trip. Go to depot, no problem. Feel fresh as. But now, I'm absolutely stumped. And on Wednesday, going up to Headland, from Pine Pines to Headland, the same 1200 kilometers. When I got there, I was out of order, basically. As soon as I got to Headland, I went, had a shower, and straight to bed without doing anything else. Just sleep. Yeah. But, on the other hand, they are reliable. They don't break. In almost 2 years, I had two breakdowns in the K200. One was with that big bird in a windscreen when I lost the windscreen. And one was recently when I was stuck for 50 hours on the side of the road. But saying that, that truck is a bit... Nobody owns that truck, it's everybody is driving. So it's been a bit trash. But yeah, apart of that, been driving the K200 for almost 2 years. I never had a problem. But they are rough. They are really, really rough. Alright guys, so we are back where we started on Tuesday night. Back in Perth, in the depot. Thanks for being part of this journey and see you next week in another trip. Don't know what I'm gonna drive, only thing I know where I'm going, but what I will have, no idea. So thanks again, and till then, take care.